Well, hello again, guys. It's Greg Olo Productions here, back again with another video. And you're probably wondering, why is the circa 1958 Electrohome apart again? Well, the strangest things happened over the past number of months. I know I last left this off in May, but there were some issues with the machine afterwards. The motor was making a grinding sound. Later on, or I don't know how many months it was, it started doing that, but it started making a grinding sound. So obviously that's not right. And then the new old stock, I don't know if it's a static now or what the heck, I don't know. I was talking to Fardmark about this stuff and he corrected me on it, so I don't even know what it is anymore. I'll have to ask him again what the cartridge is. I thought it was a static because it says a static on it, but I don't know, maybe something else is going on there. Anyway, there's some issue with the motor here, and I was talking, as I said, I was talking to him about it, and he showed me something that I didn't do. So let's get into it, shall we?
But oh, what I've got to go through, and suddenly, I guess the answer is simply to me.
So here's the bottom of the GI motor here. Not exactly sure what this part is called, but there's a bearing in there. And you can see there's a hole there, and I don't know if that hole was ever discussed in the actual, when I was doing this for the first time. I don't think I ever really talked about that hole. And I wasn't really sure what it was for, and I asked Fardmark, what the heck's this hole for? And apparently that's an oil hole. You're supposed to oil that. Well, gee, I'm like, somehow this is designed for oil to slowly go from this hole into this bearing here. Interesting stuff. You can see it just looks like a kind of a, just a hole with dust in it. Well, no, it does that. So that was a curveball for me. I wasn't expecting that. And I'm pretty sure there's one on the top of the motor as well, or the top of the I don't know what you'd call this exactly, but there's one over here as well. So, okay, well, you know, we live and learn, viewers. I don't know why it worked right the first time when I did this, but I guess, obviously, that didn't last, hence us coming back to this again. And for those of you who followed that Electrohome video step by step, I'm sorry, but I'm learning too, and that's why I'm documenting all of this, so people don't make the same mistakes as I do. Also, another interesting point here, you see that what might have been, I think it's rubber, it might have been rubber at one point, it is completely rock solid now, that red piece there. I'm pretty sure that's supposed to be some sort of rubber insulator thing, I'm not really sure, but whatever it is, it's rock solid. There's also a bit of rust on this as well, I don't know if that'll affect the performance of the motor. There, you can kind of see better. Yeah, it's not great. At least this isn't a super valuable player or something like that, you know, this is a good one to learn on. And as for the cartridge acting strange, like, I'm pretty sure the rubber, you know what, actually, I'll get back to the cartridge later. Let's fix one problem at a time, shall we? And yes, viewers, the graphenola stuff is not canceled. For those of you who saw the last part, we're waiting on some rust remover, so, you know, this is still on, okay? One thing I won't have to show you guys again is how to put these motors back together, because the one thing I did right in my older videos on this player is actually put the motor together the right way again. So I'm gonna put it together again, and we'll, you know, oil it and see what happens. Okay, apologies for the washing machine running in the background. I've got the motor together, I'm actually running it. As you can see, the tube is on, or the vacuum tube is lit up. And I hear a bit of a humming sound coming from here. That's not the caps. The caps were still good from what I know. They are the original ones, but there's no humming coming from the speaker or anything, so I don't have to recap this yet. But the motor, I don't know, it seems to be running fairly smooth. But this is without oil, so I'm gonna oil this yet and see what happens. Okay, let's try and turn this off here. Let's see what happens. Okay, that wasn't the worst. Okay, well, as I said, let's oil it and see where we get. Okay, so I'm going to be using Mobil OW-40. It works good for clock mainsprings and things like that. It's kind of a slightly thicker oil, not by much though. It's not some super thick oil or whatever. Anyway, we're gonna kinda get some in there. I don't know if you can, well, you can over-oil this, but I don't know how much it'll take for that to happen. And as you can see, I put just dipping my toothpick in the oil and then putting it in there. I don't know how much this thing will take. I can't really tell. Okay, well the oil's definitely in there, but I don't know how much it's quote unquote soaking in. I don't know what you, not really sure on that one. I guess worst case scenario is if we do end up over oiling it, all I have to do is really clean this thing out again and then just do this again, you know? I'll put one more drop in there. On my toothpick. Why do I keep calling it a Q-tip? Okay, let's try and get to the top side of this. Now, there's a slight problem with that. There is it's screwed in already, so I kind of have to loosen up the screws. Flip this thing over. Oops. Yeah, by the way, viewers, how do you guys generally work on these things? I've been flipping this thing over constantly. All kinds of crazy maneuvers and things like that. I don't think that's quite right. I don't think the people at, I don't know where this would have come from, whoever was building, or if Electrohome was building their own players at this point, I'm not really sure what was going on in the late 50s, but whoever built this, I don't think that would have been the way to do it, constantly flip it around like I am. I really don't know. Who knows, maybe you guys get the amplifier off and everything. I'm not really sure. We're going to loosen these screws up a bit here. I've already loosened the one on the right there, so we'll just kind of see how we can get this. I might have to see, my hole is right up in here somewhere, so I need to kind of might have to loosen this up a little more. I've got a lot of room yet on the screws, so I can afford to loosen these up some more. And I mean room, I mean there's still, you know, it's still sticking through the bottom here, so I can still do this without it completely falling apart on me. Yeah, in case you haven't noticed yet, I'm an amateur. Okay. I might not do this on camera due to the that wasn't smart, was it? Yeah, I might just get this. I don't know if I can get this one on camera, viewers. Okay, viewers, I actually skipped out on oiling the top side of this for two reasons. Number one, it seemed pretty well greased up there already. And also, it was way too awkward to get on camera. Like, it was, the hole must be like right over here somewhere, and it is right up against this plate. So I figured I'd never get any good actual shots of it. And, you know, you just put some oil in the hole. I think how General Industries or Electrohome would have probably done this, they would have put the motor together, oiled it, and then got it in here. And I probably should have done that as well, but but we don't have that sort of experience yet, so we're learning as we go. Okay, let's see what happens here with, okay, so the washing machine and the furnace are now on. We'll see what this player does here. Okay, no sounds yet. I might actually, you know what, I'm gonna put the turntable on and see what happens. Okay, you know what kills me about this player is there's no neutral function. So you have to scrape up against the idler wheel every single time you want the turntable to go on and off, and that's just a nuisance. Now, okay, let's turn this on here. I don't know if it's running the right speed. The motor sounds all right, but we'll see how the actual player itself here sounds. I'll just throw this on as a temporary turntable mat.
Yay.
The tube hasn't heated up yet also, so we're gonna get better sound here as this warms up.
I think it's playing the right speed. What the heck happened to the sound, though? Well, the speed issue seems to be resolved as of right now. What the heck's going on with the cartridge, though? Okay, well, at least we can move away from the motor issue that was happening here. Now we can focus on our cartridge. As all of you remember, when I installed this, there was no issues with it. But I decided to do something that may or may not have... I don't know if it messed it up or what the heck happened, but anyway. As I think all of you know, there is a rubber piece right there. And this rubber piece, I'm pretty sure it's what gets your needle to actually, well, not skip. And I don't know, it helps with the sound. Don't ask me, because I don't know what the heck I'm talking about. But anyway, this rubber piece was dry and it was causing records to skip. So I decided, okay, well, what do I do? I could replace the entire thing, or I could try a bit of my Simple Green that I was using. And Simple Green can rejuvenate rubber, and it also helps with cleaning clocks here, as you can see. So anyways, I figured, well, if I just take some Simple Green on a Q-tip and just dab a little bit on both sides of this rubber piece, maybe it could rejuvenate it a bit. Maybe it could work properly again like it did before. But it appears I've just ended up killing the... Well, I don't know if I've been killing the sound here or what the heck's going on. It might actually have more to do with the way I've got the 78 needle on here. And I don't know if she's on quite right. It looks like it is, but as you can see, the sound is non-existent. And obviously, it's not the player, because if you do this... Oh, maybe we have to let the tube heat up first. On a quick note here, I have no idea if these results here that you're seeing are actually going to last, but I thank you, Fardmark, for actually taking the time to explain how these motors... how they work. I thank you for taking the time to actually explain how to service the motor, because it seems like it wants to run now, so... And actually the right speed, too, so that's great. Anyway, you know, that's coming out of the speaker, okay? So, everything up to the cartridge is fine, except for the cartridge. And viewers, that's also max volume, by the way. That's as loud as it gets. Oh, maybe the caps do need replacing. Well, that might be the motor. Now I have no idea. Anyway, there's very little feedback coming from... I did take this needle off, and for some reason doesn't want to go back on, or doesn't want to play correctly now. So, I don't know. This worked before I took it off, but who knows? Maybe I messed it up somehow when I did that. I'm not really sure. This just pops off, by the way. There'd usually be a screw here, but in this particular version here, that's like almost like a plastic rivet or something, and you just kind of slide the back of the cartridge, or I'm sorry, the back of the needle under this rivet. And I don't think that's a very good system, because this doesn't sound right. So it's probably not adjusted properly. I'll mess around with it for a few more minutes and see what happens. Okay, there's better sound there. All I've been doing is just pushing the needle further in more. So, yeah, and also the tube has been heating up more, so maybe that has something to do with it. And also, this is a record from the 50s, which is recorded louder than a record from the 40s, which that Joe Stafford Walking My Baby Back Home, that was, I don't know what the exact year was, but... That's a 40s record, this is 50s. Well, that's more what we want right there, you know. I'm going to adjust the tremble. complete without some Johnny Reno, would it?
I went walking down by
the river. At least we're getting better sound out of this now.
Feeling
I'll keep experimenting with this, but we're not doing that.
At once I saw in the sky the little white cloud that cried. He told me.
Now, viewers, I don't know if you can hear that, but it's a bit of a... You can hear a little bit of a thumping noise. Not half as bad, though. I don't know. Is that passable? What do you guys think? We're also kind of getting this sort of scratchy sound on the high notes. If you listen to Cry here... Hold, actually, maybe I'll put the little white cloud that cried back on again. There's my temporary turntable. Or a turntable mat. Oh. Here we go, here, let's try this. It's not there yet.
I went walking.
Oh, there it is.
Down by
it's kind of a metallic screeching, I don't know if you can hear that.
Feeling very sad inside.
Kind of sounds like a gramophone. When you don't replace the gaskets and they get all dry.
River. Feeling very sad inside.
Yeah, I don't think something is adjusted quite right. Hey, at least the treble does something about this, though. I'm adjusting it, and it's actually making a difference. That's great. Now, obviously, there's not going to be some incredible bass on this, because it's just a little 1-2 chord. Put that cartridge in there. I don't know. Something's still not quite right.
Sonny, you hear this? I love you as I never loved before. Hear this, I'm sorry.
I don't know. Maybe I should get that top side of the rotor, the motor, oiled. I mean, it's making a light thumping sound, but it's not terrible. Oh yeah, you know what this is.
Now I've got a guy and his name is Dooley. He's my guy and I love him truly. He's not good looking. Heaven knows, but I'm wild.
It might be stupid to catch a rarer record like this on a portable like this, but...
He wears tan shoes with pink shoelaces.
A
polka dot vest and man oh man wears tan shoes with pink shoelaces and a big Panama with a purple hat band.
Before the angels come to carry me, I want it down.
Okay, that was a scratch that was already there anyway. So, you know, I mean, here, if we actually look at the condition of this,
you can see that there's some to be desired there. Is that there? So, not really surprised that that skipped. Although on the BSR, it does great. It doesn't skip on there. Okay, I better stop before someone calls the police on me. Yeah, I didn't love the bass on that, on the Fleetwoods one. It comes softly to me. This one's in alright shape. You know, I mean, this one's been worn a bit too, so. And as for the B-side. Yeah, something's still not right for the part. I need a second opinion. Okay, as much as we like that, that's kind of off topic. I don't know, viewers, what do you think? Is something seriously wrong with the cartridge? Does the player need to be recapped? Is something still wrong with the motor? I have no idea. I guess we'll see in the comments here what they generate, and we'll see what happens in the next part of this little series here. Anyways, viewers, I appreciate you actually watching and commenting, as a lot of you do. And yeah, we'll see. We'll leave this all here for now, and we'll see what comes of it. I don't know. It's an interesting little quote-unquote predicament here. It's probably working. A scale, 10 out of 10 scale of it actually working is probably about, I don't know, a 7. You know, there's some minor things that seem to not be quite right with this.